So we're going to talk now about the symptoms of type 2 diabetes. And if you think back to the section that explained how type 2 developed, this will make a lot of sense to you. So the first symptom is tiredness, real fatigue. And at first that might not make much sense. Your blood sugar's high, you've got lots of energy in your blood, but you're feeling really tired. But think back to Katie's box and the balls falling into the box. As the insulin isn't working properly, it's not letting that glucose get into your body's cells. So your blood sugar is getting higher, but the cells aren't getting the energy they need. And that's why often, as type 2 develops, you can feel increasingly tired. Another symptom that's very common is needing to go to the loo a lot more, especially at night. And that's because your body is desperately trying to get rid of that sugar that's in the blood. It needs to get that sugar into the cells, but too much sugar in the blood, as we'll go on to explain, is actually really damaging to the blood vessels. So your body will try and get rid of that in any way it can, and the easiest way to do that is in your urine. As you're weeing more often, you'll probably feel a lot more thirsty. You may also find that your vision is affected. Some people find that their vision starts to get a bit blurry around the time of their diagnosis. And actually, sometimes that's one of the symptoms that prompts them to go to the doctor in the first place. And that's because the sugar is starting to affect the lens in the eye. Long term, it can actually affect the blood vessels in the eye. And we'll go on to talk about that later. If you get a cut or a graze, you may find it takes a lot longer to heal. And that, again, is due to having too much sugar in the blood. Too much sugar in the blood means it's harder for your blood to move around that oxygen and those white blood cells that fight bacteria. And as well, we know that bacteria that lives all over us, even if we've only just had a wash, normally that's not doing us any harm. But if we have diabetes and we have a cut or a graze, that bacteria is going to feast on all of that sugar. So it's going to be a lot more virulent. So it'll be harder for your body to heal. And a final symptom that some people find is that their love lives can be affected. And that is, unfortunately, because this higher blood sugar can affect all the delicate blood vessels and all of those delicate organs. Now, some of you may be watching this and thinking, yeah, I got that one. Yeah, I realised I had that one. I knew there was something wrong when I went to the GP. Others of you might be thinking, well, I haven't had any of those symptoms. So what's going on? And what research shows us is that everyone actually gets symptoms, but they're very gradual. And if you have a bit of a think about those symptoms, especially weeing more often, being more thirsty, being more tired, skin not healing as quickly, we might just think that we're getting a bit older. But this isn't about getting old. This is about having too much sugar in the blood. And the good news about that, that we're going to talk about later, is that there is something you can do about that. Now, I want to talk here about the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes. We often get asked, does type 1, is it worse than type 2? If I've got type 2, will it eventually become type 1? It's really important to understand that there are actually two separate conditions. So we've seen how type 2 evolves through a bit of inherited factors, a pancreas not working as well as it should, but very largely lifestyle factors. And that's about the food we eat, the activity we get, and as we're going to go on to talk about, the amount of stress we have in our lives and the amount of sleep we get. Those four things have a huge impact on our lifestyles and whether or not we develop type 2 diabetes. Type 1 is a separate disorder. It's actually an autoimmune condition. And it's about the pancreatic cells that produce the insulin being attacked by the body's own immune system. So type 1s don't have any insulin in their system. And as a consequence, they'll have really similar symptoms, but they come on a lot more suddenly. And finally, just to round up, thinking about that question of type 1 or type 2, which is the more serious? Well, actually, they're both really serious. Type 2, typically the symptoms develop more slowly and the long-term complications have a slower onset. but they're very similar to those that can occur with type 1. And type 2 is something that you must take seriously.